Let's look at the character of Ariel in The Tempest. Now, Ariel is an airy spirit who Prospero had helped because he was trapped. He'd been entrapped inside a tree by Caliban's mother, who's a witch. Prospero freed Ariel from the tree, and in return, he became indebted and he agreed to become a servant to Prospero. Now, Ariel is the person who directly causes the storm to occur, which shipwrecks the King of Naples, Alfonso's ship. However, it's also Ariel that's tasked with making sure the ship on its return and all these people, when they return back to Milan and back to Italy, they are safe. Now, he also plays music, which sends some of the characters to sleep, which sends other characters to wake up, which also leads them to sometimes feel like they are going crazy. And he is the person who primarily, or rather the spirit that primarily helps Prospero in hatching his plans. He is also the spirit that overhears Caliban's decision, or rather Caliban's plot to try and kill Prospero. So he does also inform Prospero of this plot. And at the end of the story, Ariel is granted freedom by Prospero. Now, of course, if you're writing about his character, there are some key quotes you need to be aware of. And of course, also with The Tempest as a whole, if you're studying this play for your coursework or exams and you are considering the supernatural aspect of the story, he is certainly a very important character to talk about. So what I've done is I've selected all the relevant quotations to bear in mind for his character, as well as the word level analysis you can do when discussing these quotations in your coursework or exams. So let's get started with the first quotation. Now, Ariel states when he first appears, and of course this is where we see that he clearly is indebted, he's basically a slave to Prospero. He states, "All hell, great master." Now, this is an exclamatory sentence. Remember, an exclamatory sentence is a sentence that shows a strong feeling or somebody shouting. And here he's basically saying, "All hell, Prospero." And this is obviously showing his servitude, his position of being a servant, a slave, essentially, to Prospero. Also, you want to focus in terms of the word level analysis on the assonance of A in "all hell, great and master." Okay, so here we find that and the relationship initially in the play is established between Ariel and Prospero, Ariel being his servant who is indebted to him. And of course, as a result of that, he listens to everything Prospero asks him to do, and he carries that out very dutifully, which contrasts Caliban, who is a very rebellious slave towards Prospero to the extent that he even plots to have him killed. Now, the second quotation is when Ariel actually reminds Prospero he is supposed to have already been freed by Prospero, but he hasn't done that. And he states, "Is there more toil? Since thou dost give me pains, let me remember thee what thou hast promised, which is not yet performed." So here's reminding him that by the, you know, the year has passed and you'd promised me that I was gonna have my freedom, but you haven't, okay? So I'm still carrying out the work that you've asked me, Prospero, but you haven't repaid me my freedom as yet. So I'm just reminding you. Now here, the word level analysis you want to do is firstly the semantic field of work, which is toil, which means work, and of course pains. Pains here is not in terms of him feeling pain. It's the pain that he's engaging in terms of working for Prospero, doing all that Prospero wishes him to do. The other word level analysis you want to do is the repetition of thou, which means you. Okay, this is Old English, so this is a pronoun in Old English relating to you. And finally, the alliteration of P in promised and performed in this quotation. Okay, now the third quote, and this is when Ariel deliberately misleads Ferdinand, Alfonso's son, into believing that his father, Alfonso, the King of Naples, has drowned in the shipwreck because Ferdinand is the first person to be washed ashore. He tells him this very, very famous song, "Four fathom five, their father lies, of his bones are coral made," ellipsis. So now here what he's basically saying in his song, so he's singing this song to Ferdinand, he's basically telling him that his father is deep in the water, okay? Remember that fathom is a very old metric talking about depths of the ocean, okay? So he's five depths down, describing how Ferdinand's father, Alonso, has been drowned. And also, in terms of his bones are coral made. This is what we could call a dysphemism. Remember that a dysphemism is a very deliberately, somewhat inappropriate way of stating a very harsh fact or a harsh reality. The dysphemism that Ariel is using here is to make it really, really clear in his song to Ferdinand that his father, the King of Naples, has been killed in this tempestuous ocean, okay? And this is all entering within Prospero's plan of getting Ferdinand to become very vulnerable, and then he's going to meet Miranda and fall in love with her, okay? And he feels like he's the only survivor of this shipwreck. Now, the word level analysis you want to do here is the alliteration of F in 4, fathom, 5, father, and of course this is supposed to be a song, so the alliteration kind of adds the sing-song element to this statement. And as I mentioned, this is a dysphemism, but also the word level analysis you can mention here is hyperbole, over exaggeration, okay? So remember, dysphemism is the opposite of euphemism. Euphemism is a very kind way to refer to something that's maybe a little bit harsh. Dysphemism is the opposite. It's a deliberately harsh way of referring to something that's painful or inappropriate. In this case, of course, he's referring deliberately in a very harsh way to Ferdinand's father having been killed in order to basically misguide him and make Ferdinand think that his dad has died in the shipwreck. The next quotation to bear in mind is when Ariel says, "You are three men of sin." This is when he's approaching the men, okay? The shipwrecked men, and he's particularly directing these remarks towards Antonio, Prospero's brother who betrayed him, and Alfonso. This is the King of Naples, and he's telling them that they basically, he's reminding them of the treachery that they engaged him to in order to remove Prospero from the throne when he used to be the Duke of Milan. Now here, the word level analysis you want to do in this declarative sentence, remember, a declarative sentence is a sentence that states a fact, feeling, a mood. So Ariel here is basically telling these men that they were engaged in a conspiracy against Prospero, that he's trying to make them remember and feel guilty about this betrayal. But also you want to look at and focus on this assonance of E in R, three men. Now the next quotation that Ariel says that's relevant to bear in mind is when he's talking to Prospero and he's saying, yes, I remember, you know, that he makes it clear that he understands that there's a time limit to when Prospero, basically, if he is successful, he's going to renounce his magical abilities. And Ariel reconfirms this by saying, "On the sixth hour, ellipsis, my lord, you said our work should cease." So here he's basically telling Prospero, yep, I remember what you told me. You know, we're going to stop all of this work, and you're also going to renounce your magical abilities on the sixth hour. Now, the word level analysis you want to focus on mainly here with this quotation, and this is the quotation that basically signals to us as the audience that Prospero's time is coming to an end on this island, and he is going to have a positive ending. He is going to be able to return back to Italy and reclaim his title as the Duke of Milan. Now, what you want to focus on is the sibilance here of sixth, said, and should. The next quotation that Ariel says is when he states, "Your charm so strongly works them that if you now beheld them, your affections would become tender." Here, what he is telling Prospero is he has so successfully enchanted these men. He has so successfully, these men that he shipwrecked, he has so successfully disoriented them that if he were to see just how disoriented these men are, his enemies, he would maybe even forget that he's angry at them and feel really sorry for them. That's how successfully his charm has worked on these men. Now, the word level analysis you want to focus on here is firstly the repetition of the pronoun your and the sibilance of S in so strongly, okay? Now, do bear in mind that Ariel and Prospero do have a good relationship, even if Prospero didn't necessarily keep his promise to release him early on. However, at the end of the play, Prospero does remember this promise that he made. He does release Ariel. And also, on the other hand, we can see that Ariel really is very, very loyal to Prospero. He helps him in his plans. And of course, he also contributes to the success of Prospero by the end of the play.